All right. Misty, you're here. Thank you so much for joining us this evening and being our special guest. You know, it's really an honor for all of us. I know you know my wife very well, so now you get to know me, right? And I know you probably know many members on this panel. Tell us about your role at SunServe.
Oh, gosh. I wear many, many, many hats. Currently, I am the Director of Women's Services at SunServe and the Director of Education and Training. And I basically have two primary jobs. My first primary job that I'm focusing on a lot right now is going into corporate America and doing LGBTQ/transgender 101 proficiency and sensitivity trainings. And I go into hospitals, I go into clinics, I go into therapy situations, police stations, fire departments. And I cater my training to you. So if I'm talking to a therapist, I put you in the mindset of what it would be like to be trans and or LGBTQ. And I talk about all the letters, LGBTQQAAAIP2S. And then I talk about the history of transgender. For example, the first word for trans was transvestite. It was created in the year 1901 by Dr. Magnus Hirschfeld. And then I go into all of that and basically the fact that being trans is not a choice. Why on earth would a person choose to be the most marginalized community in the world, the most hated and hate crime, and nobody wants to hire you because you don't fit into our safe, comfortable boxes? And then I go into the history. Well, like, okay, well, how long has this been around? Oh, did you know that the first transgender person was 10,000 years ago? In the year 7000 BC, the Neolithic cave drawings were on the walls, and the archaeologists had a word for transgender. Before trans was a word, it was called third sex and third gender. Because on these walls, they had men and women and female hair, female breasts, and male genitalia. This is not a new phenomenon. It is not a new thing. Yes, we are getting exposure, but it has always been around. And one of my other favorite historical facts is the year 200 BC, there were so many trans people. Hindu law tried to explain why that would be a phenomenon, why we would exist. And of course, it was antiquated 200 years before Christ or before Common Era. But the law said if a great quantity of male seed was present, a male child is born. If a great quantity of female seed is present, a female child is born. We now know that there's one egg, unless you're fraternal twins. But they tried to explain it because there were so many trans people. We're not new. Most people, it takes a lot. Like, for example, Caitlyn Jenner, she waited 65 years to accept and love herself. And that's the true journey of a transgender person. Many people try to distract or hide or push down, but it's not a choice. You can get drunk or high every single day, but guess what? You're going to wake up one day and you're still there. Mm. You can't hide from yourself. You can numb the pain.
Wow.
But you're really you.
Facts. Facts.
And my second job.
That's really
my second job. My second job is as the Director of Women's Services. I do help LGBTQ women. Notice there's no G in women, but LGBTQ women navigate their many hurdles. And yes, most of my clients are transgender masculine or transgender feminine, and I help them navigate their many hurdles. Name change, gender marker change, finding a doctor that's not going to treat you as a petri dish, but also teach you as a human being. Oh, I have a cough. Maybe because you're transgender. No, I have a cough because I have a cough. I'm also transgender because I'm transgender. And so I help them. There's many, many, you wouldn't believe. Well, some of you might believe.
I would.
You wouldn't believe the hurdles in a trans person's life. And I help you navigate all of those. And it's we believe in full wraparound case management and handholding because it's a tough journey. That's my two jobs.
So let me ask you before we we gloss over any. Why did you choose SunServe?
SunServe chose me.
Okay.
So as most of you know, for the last 19 years, I've been an entertainer in the nightclub industry, literally doing drag every single day. And when Donald Trump became president, is when I decided I needed my name changed. And my birth name was androgynous, but it bothered me. So finally, when he became the White House, I started hearing all these like hating out loud, and I'm like, you know what? I'm going to go change. So I walked into SunServe to help have them help me get my name changed. And the executive director was like, stop. Who are you? What's going on? You are a large and lovely woman with the X factor. You demand attention. And I think I can use that. So we started like, a couple hours a week and do this and do that. And now I'm full time.
All right.
Wow.
Nice.
Well, in your three most important, I guess, actions that you would like to see the gay community, the LGBTQAI community, do more of to support our trans brothers and sisters, what are those three things?
Well, one of the things you guys just talked about, and I was listening to you off stage. Wow. I mean, I'm on the same, not even the same neighborhood, the same house, same floor, same bedroom even. I totally agree with the segregation of our community. And I've emceed Wicked Manners every year since inception. I've emceed Stonewall most of its years since 2005. And the best thing about those events is you can look out and see gay, straight, bi, trans. And in our community, walking down the street, I live in our community, but my office is right in the heart of Wilton Manners. Mm-hmm. And I see a lot of people, and I see the way we look at each other and we treat each other. Oh, you're too skinny, I don't talk to twinks. Or you're a bear, I don't talk mm-hmm. to bears. And we fight for equality, but we can't get equality within our own neighborhood. Mm-hmm. And that is a huge, huge, huge problem. And trans people, unless there's a drag show, are not often welcome in gay spaces.
Hello.
And that is a huge problem as well. And I understand not all trans people are gay. I am not a lesbian. I've tried it in college, no offense. In fact,
we all worked all the hype.
I tried to force myself, but I couldn't. I couldn't. I am not a lesbian. I am a straight woman. But sometimes, unless I'm performing, I don't even feel welcome in my own bars. Mm. And I have fought for equality. Like, I always use the joke, I'm not gay, but I got your back. Mm. And I all wow. will always have your back. But
so
I
Misty
Eyez,
what are those three things? What are the three things you want to see? You get a chance to tell 350,000 viewers right now, a part of our LGBT community, broadcasting from the gayest place on planet Earth. What are you telling those viewers, our gay community? What are you telling them right now? What are the three things, the actions they need to take in order to support our trans brothers and sisters?
So the first thing I said was stop segregating. The second thing I said was love each other. And the third thing is going to be the hardest. Love yourself.
Boom.
Because if you don't love yourself, you're going to start picking at each other. Like, oh, I'm feeling fat today, so you're ugly. And did you know that you have this problem? And oh, look at that. That yellow doesn't even look cute. And guess what? I'm still not cute. So, I mean, I'm picking the brightest. Shiny things get stones thrown at them. And so I'm just picking on you for that reason. But
that's a deep statement.
But if you love yourself, why do you got to put other people down?
Mm. Yeah. Whoa.
So I'm going to go ahead and take it from here with, if you love yourself, why would you put anyone down? And on our road to Stonewall right now.
Hold on. Before we go to Stonewall, I can't let Misty leave without asking her a question. Back to the you're not a lesbian thing. please tell me about this thing that you did. You and my sister Kitty Meow made out. If that ain't lesbian, bitch.
Okay, I'll let that slide.
What?
Was I'll let that one slide.
Okay.
After dark.
Ain't no slide. And I can't let this opportunity pass.
All right.
Girl.
Well.
Kai.
Okay. I think there were landmine around here.
I will like to use the argument that everyone is straight or gay. Like, I use the analogy, spaghetti is straight until you boil it.
Yeah.
We all have our boiling point. However, in this specific situation, Kitty and I were performing a drag suicide number, and it was Katy Perry's I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It. And girl, when you're on stage and people are looking at you, you do things for the sake of entertainment.
Somebody
value.
Had to pick that song ahead of time, though, girl.
I've sucked dick on stage for the sake of literally in a song.
So I can honestly say I've not kissed a girl unless I was on stage since college.
All right.
You're an inspiration, by the way, and we're so thankful.
Thank you so much.
Misty Eyez, thank you for joining us.
And if anybody needs help, please reach out to me. You can contact me through sunserve.org or call the main number and they will transfer you to me. My extension is 126, and I'm here to help everyone, LGBTQ women specifically, or transgender, anything. I can help you. The life can be hard for all of us, and Sunserve helps everyone. So if you need help with anything and I can't help you, I know who can.
Thanks so much for watching us. If you like what you saw, please subscribe to our channel and follow us on Facebook.